Oh, isn't Burton-on-Sea a lovely place first thing in the morning? If you ignore the power plant, and the sewage works, and the fish-gutting factory. Oh, look, there's Alex's house. She's arm-wrestling her fiancé for first go in the shower. She always wins. Not because he lets her. She's just much stronger than he is. And there's Lucy and Colin making breakfast for the two little girls. At least I think they're girls. It's so hard to tell these days. And there's Jo and her husband Kev, snoring like wild animals. Now where's Mel? Oh, there she is. She's single. And before you ask, Mel, I'm married, so it's a no.
Hi, I'm Mel. I'm whispering because I'm in bed with a man I met last night in a bar. We drank 46 tequila shots and a schooner of sherry. That's him.
Ooh, I think he's waking up.
Good morning, lover.
Bugger me.
No, you were the perfect gentleman.
Yes. I mean, thank goodness.
Hang on, where are you going?
Home to change, then to work.
But this is your home, and you said you worked from home.
Yes, I do, but I have a second home where I keep all my clothes. I better go there now, quickly, at once, to change for work, then back to this house for work.
Okay, then. Bye. I think he really likes me. I better get going too, or I'll be late for the office. I carpool with Colin. Well, it's a bike pool, really. He's got a tandem. I'm having a coffee with Lucy, his wife. She's one of my best friends. Which is odd, because normally short people frighten me.
Do you want sugar?
Oh, yes, 8, please.
Colin won't be long. He's just plaiting Veronica's hair and changing Holly's nappy.
Oh, right. Hey, Lucy, I'm considering dating these men. Here, look, what do you think of him? He's very keen.
Yeah, he's okay, I suppose.
Him? He's almost desperate for me, that one.
Yeah, he's nice, kind-looking.
Him?
Bit beardy. Why are they wearing orange jumpsuits?
They're on death row, Lucy. But the important thing is they are all definitely single. I must remember to phone my mate Jo. She said she knows someone who knows someone who knows someone who knows a single man. Brilliant! Jo works as a beauty therapist at Dave's Sensation Spa and Beauty.
If you just relax, Mrs. Wilkinson, while Jo and I begin the hydroactive mineral salt scrub.
Dave, have you ever been to a orgy?
What?
How's your father at an orgy?
A what?
Orgy. Kev and I are going to become orgiasts. I want to share, Kev. I feel it's selfish of me to keep all that man to myself.
Believe me, it's not.
Kev is an exceptional lover, Dave. Almost carnal. Sometimes I literally start weeping.
Right, I'm not sure I want to know this.
Hey, maybe you and Alex would, you know,
before you tie the knot.
No thanks, I'm a one-man woman.
Do you mean one-woman man, Dave?
Yes. So, Kev wants to sleep with other women, does he?
No, he's not keen.
Right. But you want him to?
I think it's important other women experience him.
Kev is pythonic, Dave.
Right.
That means exceedingly...
Yeah, I get the picture, Joe.
I've got pictures, Dave. They're on our website. www.ohmythatcan'tbereal. Has that been photoshopped? No, it jolly well hasn't. That's real.co.uk.
Poor old Dave's engaged to Alex, my boss. She loves telling Colin and me what to do. We ignore her. I mean, she's not the boss of me. Well, she is literally the boss of me, obviously, but not spiritually. I'm the boss of me. Me! I'm the boss of me.
Right, everyone!
Oh, she's coming.
Okay, guys, we had a poor week recruitment-wise, so this week we're going to need some big placements. Colin, what are you aiming for?
To be in the pub every night by five.
Oh, very funny, Colin. Now, seriously, what are your targets?
To be in the pub every night by five.
Colin, naughty step. Mel, you're looking very smug.
Well, Alex, as a matter of fact, I've just secured a new client who has a number of positions that need filling.
Colin?
Yes, Alex.
Off the naughty step, front and centre. It looks like Mel could be stealing the special recruitment shield from under your nose.
Oh, no.
So tell all, Mel.
Well, it is commission-based, but with potentially very high earnings.
Excellent, excellent.
The clients are looking for inventive, career-minded candidates, women only.
Sexist.
Sensible.
Good communicators who are well turned out and happy to work flexible hours.
Well, we've got plenty of candidates who fit the bill.
And preferably with some previous experience.
Of what?
Pole dancing.
Mel, naughty step.
Oh. I envy Alex because she's got her own office. It's made of glass. She looks like a big, bossy trout floating about in a fish tank. Only she never has a string of poo hanging from her like fish. Lucy's popped in to say hello on her way to pick up Holly from Tumbletots.
Hi, Alex. Sorry to bother you. Is Colin around, or is he busy bringing in thousands of pounds worth of international business?
He's filing.
I'm just dropping off his lunch.
Now, Lucy, what about you?
Me?
Don't you think it's time to climb back on the horse of business and gallop into the sunset?
Yeah, not sure I'm ready to go back to work.
Don't be ridiculous. Your children are getting older and you need it. Your brain is turning to mush. Your sparkle is gone. Lucy, you were once a vibrant, strong-minded businesswoman. At times, I even saw glimmers of myself in you.
Really?
Only the tiniest glimmers, mind.
Well, if the truth be known, Alex, I'm frightened.
Oh!
What did you do that for?
Come on, Lucy. Pull yourself together. Get strong.
That really hurts.
Don't be such a crybaby.
My cheek's smarting.
Where's your fight, Lucy? Come on. Get angry. Take back your life.
Ow! Stop slapping me!
That's it, Lucy. I can see a glimmer of fire.
Stop hitting me!
What are you going to do about it, little legs?
Lucy, Lucy, stop it!
Lucy, you're deranged.
What's going on?
She made me, Colin.
Alex is my boss, Lucy. You can't put her in a half Nelson. Alex, are you okay?
Well, Colin, I'm fabulous. That was brilliant, Lucy. Wish I'd had the camcorder on you. Your eyes were alive. How do you feel?
Strangely elated.
I'm strangely aroused.
Colin, this isn't about you.
Sorry.
It's about adrenaline. It's a wonderful thing. Lucy, you're ready.
For what?
To go back to work, of course. Colin, could you get me an ambulance? Lucy Rabbit punched me and I think I've got a collapsed lung.
I rang Joe and got that mystery single man's number. He's called Hugo, and apparently he's just my type. Male. Colin found the whole rabbit-punching collapsed lung very stressful, so he's gone to see Joe for a spine-elongating massage.
Right, Colin. If you could just roll over onto your tummy for me. Oh! Colin, your back, it's...
Hairy. I know. Lucy loves it. Calls me her monkey love.
Ooh, right. Wow.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.